Oh. Yeah. That was quite cool, actually, wasn't it? Like, even when I did it, I was like, that wasn't actually that bad. Now, it's March the 21st, and we were having a bit of an argument before, and somebody said it's the solstice. I said, no, it's not the solstice. It's the one between one solstice and another solstice. It's the epiphanidin. It's the equinox. That's what it is. It's the equinox. And equinox, I thought equinox was a topical cream that you rubbed on. Users of equinox sometimes experience itching. Do you ever get that in the drug commercials when they tell you that they have to, for legal reasons, tell you the side effects of the drugs, and they're so bad, you're like, I would rather have the illness than risk the side effect, you know. If you take this drug, your ass will fall off. I'm like, no, what? You know what, for dandruff, I'll risk the dandruff. 20% of users who used Equinox, their asses fell off. They're like, no, I'm fine. I'll wear a hat. Is Equinox really a cream? It's not really. Say it's not really a cream. Do they advertise in CBS? Because that's usually my luck. I talk about something and then they go, well, you can't say that because Equinox are a big sponsor of tonight's show. And they actually recently defended a lawsuit when someone's ass fell off. Anyway, you good?
I'm good, man. I'm just enjoying watching you dig that hole.
Well, looks like things are back to normal around here.
Ferguson, sponsored by Thermacare Heat Wraps. For up to 16 hours of back pain relief, try Thermacare. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Comedian is out of there. You now are in the hands of a professional whore. I will take you places you've never been before in your life. There are new levels of lame and boredom you would not believe is possible. I've just noticed how high up my tie is tonight. I hate when I come out and the tie's too high. There's nothing I can do about it now. I have to try and adjust my body. But, like, then when I'm like this, I always start thinking, put the lotion in the basket. Put the lotion in the basket. There's a long way from the bottom of the tie to Shangri-La. It's a great day for America. Yeah, it is. It is. It is. It's, I tell you, Wednesday, March the 21st is the day I wait for. Oh, it is, isn't it? Yeah. Wednesday, March the 21st. I wait for this day all year. On March the 20th, I'm like, one more day. It's the third hump day in March. As you can tell from my tie. No, I am actually very excited today, as you can tell from my tie. I'm very excited today because there's only two more days until Friday, and then Friday, the movie The Hunger Games is coming out, and I'm like, yeah! I'm very excited about this. Do we have a poster for The Hunger Games over there? Look at that. Well, no wonder they're hungry. Look, they've got the turkey right up in the sky there. It's got a great cast, this movie. It's got Jennifer Lawrence plays Katniss, and they've got the beautiful Elizabeth Banks, who's here tonight. She's playing Effie Trinket. I like the name Effie Trinket. Sounds a little bit like Downton Abbey. Sounds like a maid in Downton Abbey, doesn't it, Effie Trinket? Why, it's Effie Trinket, the downstairs scullery maid.
Oh, hello, I'm sorry to disturb you.
Effie Trinket, please, come over here and bend over this coal scuttle so I can... So I can examine your credentials.
I couldn't help but notice that your tie is the map to Shangri-La.
Yeah. Well, what happened, Effie Trinket, is back when I was out hunting in India, I used to wear this tie to distract tigers. I would walk around the tiger fields of India wearing this tie, and the tigers would go, "This tie's a little short." And then I would pounce, Effie Trinket, pounce, just like I'm going to do to you right now.
Oh, dear.
Anyway, that's who's in the movie. Oh, yeah, you know who else is in The Hunger Games? The guy from American Beauty, Wes Bentley, you know the... Do we have a picture of him from The Hunger Games? Look, there he is. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. He's playing the villain who's called... Evil guy, creepy beard. See it again? Yeah, see, I once shaved my whiskers like that. Not the whiskers on my face, though. And sure enough, I also created an out-of-control villain. He lives in Shangri-La. Anyway, the... This show is so crap tonight. Now, The Hunger Games is based on the best-selling book. It's very tricky turning a book into a movie because sometimes people love the book so much, no adaptation lives up to what they imagine. Now, you can avoid that disappointment very simply by never reading books. I really like the name The Hunger Games, but I always confuse it with that HBO show, The Game of Thrones. I always get them mixed up. And I'm thinking The Hunger Game of Thrones. I always get stuff mixed up. I once ordered a... I'm not kidding. I ordered a Fight Club sandwich at Subway once. like a Fight Club sandwich. I'm like... We won't talk about that. Anyway, here's how I keep the Hunger Games and the Game of Thrones straight. The Hunger Games is the movie starring the girl with the bow and arrow. The Game of Thrones is the one with the extremely talented actor who's a little person. Or is that Mission Impossible? I can never remember. You see what I did there? Did you see what I did there? Anyway, The Hunger Games is set in a post-apocalyptic America. You know, it's a reality show in which young people are forced to try and kill each other. Kids fighting on TV for our amusement? Isn't this the Jersey Shore? What I don't get, though, if it's a post-apocalyptic America, right? There's been the apocalypse, it wrecks civilization, but everyone still has cable. Do you see? I could survive years underground as long as I have Bravo. A lot of people are comparing The Hunger Games to Twilight, but that is thematically accurate because The Hunger Games takes place in a futuristic dystopia, whereas Twilight books are, what's the literary term again? Crap. That's right, I said it. That's right, Twihards. As far as I'm concerned, you're all Hufflepuffs. That's right. I still love Harry Potter. I have dreams about that little English fella. Call me David Beckham. But what, my collar's out?
with you? Were you laughing at my collar? My collar? Oh, look at that. Oh, let me just do it properly. Oh, I can get my tie lower. Oh, this will work out great. Tie will get lower, collar comes up. Weird. I stopped drinking alcohol about 20 years ago and I still look like a drunk. I'm buttoning up my thing. Yeah, relax, man. It's all right. The sensor's cool. It's all right. I didn't actually cuss while I was doing it.
Shangri-La.
Are you going to go and see the Hunger Games?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
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 Are you going to, you like the Twilight or the Harry Potter?
Love the Harry Potter.
Yeah, I love the Harry Potter too. I like the, are you a Hufflepuff or a Gryffindor?
Oh, I'm.
Slytherin. You'll be a Slytherin.
Yeah, that's, yeah. No.
Yeah, well, that's, that doesn't matter. You can be gay and you can be any one of the four houses. You can be Ravenclaw for us, as far as I'm concerned.
Well, you really need to get out more.
Yeah. Nah, man, don't knock the Harry Potter alchemore there, and I'll just simply unplug you. Well, hey! My robot, my rules.
If you come over here, I'll give you a Shangri-La little tickle.
All right, do the thing.
Sure. Tonight's program is brought to you by the shocking Noothler, the Hunger Crying Game. Eat it at your own risk.
Equinox special, where tonight we're celebrating Equinox and all its uses as a topical cream. Do you celebrate Equinox in community?
Yeah, love the Equinox.
Yeah. Is that a big thing for the gay robot skeleton community then?
Yeah, all the gay robots get together and celebrate.
All right. Do you know any idea or... what time?
Well, I'd love to tell you.
Huh? What?
I'd love to tell you.
You'd love to tell me what?
What time it is.
Well, I was trying to lead you in that direction.
No, I saw he was being very casual about it.
Yeah, well, I'm just trying, I'm trying to, make it look like a TV show where, like, people actually talk to each other instead of just me talking to a ooh-la-la appliance. It's not a cuss word, it's a slang word in Germany. But you go then.
Tonight's Tweet Mail segment is brought to you by Equinox Cream. Does your Shangri-La have an itch? Try Equinox.
Plus your email. All right, this is from Amy in Boise, Idaho. You ever been to Boise, Idaho?
Yeah, I love Boise.
You like it in Boise, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, you like Boise. Hey. You see what I'm doing here, right?
Yeah, no, I see.
Yeah, you get what I'm doing.
Boise.
Yeah. Boise, yeah. All right. Hi, Craig and Jeff. The belief is that women are attracted to men with a good sense of humor. But do you think men are easily turned on by... You bet we are. Yeah, funny. Well, you know what a sense of humor suggests to me? That someone is adventurous sexually. That's true. I mean, if someone doesn't have a sense of humor, they'd be like, do you like that? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's... Ooh, boy, yeah. Right there. Don't stop. Whereas, you know, you get someone with a sense of humor, they're like... Arr-ra! This is from Ben in Salem, Oregon. You ever been there?
Oh, yeah.
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 What do you do in Salem?
That's where all the gay robots get together.
Oh, is that where, that where the big Equinox
the big
parade
Equinox
is?
Parade. That's
yeah, all right. Hi, Craig and Jeff. I am fairly new to doing stand-up. How do you psych yourself up before doing a show? Can you believe this? Psych myself up! I don't psych my... Do you do any bending and stretching before the show or anything like that?
No, I like to whip myself with a cat of nine tails.
Yeah. Now, a lot of people, they get weird little things before they come out and do it. You see what I'm doing here, right? Yeah, you see what I'm doing? Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Okay.
Boise.
This is from April in Philadelphia. It says, hi, Craig and Jeff. Would you ever consider having a line of fashionable socks? You mean like these? The thing is about these is that these aren't socks. I'm actually wearing pantyhose. Or mantyhose, as they are now called. Yeah, these go all the way up. Actually, that's not true. I don't think it should be legal for men to wear. You know, they have that pantyhose that's now mantyhose? But I don't think it's good because if it. Well, look, you think about this. A garment in a man which acts both as socks and the underpants with no air holes or movement in between, all bound up at the top by a piece of elastic. I mean, right there, you're looking at some kind of Greenpeace event.
Yeah, there's going to be some kind of civil war in Shangri-La.
Yeah, that's right. All would not be well in Shangri-La with that kind of confinement. I hope that helps. This is from Melanie in Clearwater, Florida. You ever been there?
No.
How about Clearwater? You ever been there? Yeah. Dear Craig and Jeff, I recently got divorced. Ah, this will be sad. Any suggestions on how I should celebrate? Jeff?
Well, if you come to Salem, there's a bunch of gay robots.
You might want to go to the big Equinox parade. Oh, hey, there's only 37 seconds left. We've got all these to do. We have to do a speed reading.
All right,
ready? All right, here we go. This is from Shelley in Santa Barbara, California. Ever been there?
No, I love it.
All right, dear Craig and Jeff, I think my daughter really believes she's getting a pony for her birthday this weekend. How do I let her down gently? You bitch! This is from Kevin in Stamford, Connecticut. Hey, Craig and Jeff, I keep getting sexual texts from some random number I don't recognize. How should I respond?
First, I want to apologize.
All right, this is from Courtney in Minneapolis, in Minnesota. I don't know if you can tell from the picture, but Courtney's one of them great crested grebe tit things. Hi, Craig and Jeff. I enjoy watching reality television, but my boyfriend can't stand it. Is there a compromise? Oh, God. No, get divorced. Finally, this is from Adam in Mesquite, Texas. You ever been there?
Sure, love it. Yeah, it's great.
All right. Dear Craig and Jeff, what's a good alternative to the usually first date of dinner in a movie? I'd say, what about the Equinox Parade in Salem, Oregon? A lot of people enjoy that, right?
Yeah, and after that, rub a little Equinox cream on your...
That's it. You know, you get your Equinox cream, you rub it on your the areas affected, and then you get out to the gay robot parade. You know, I would say, though, that having a robot parade, you probably should pick a less rainy spot than Oregon. Oregon, a lot of rain in Oregon. I would think, maybe, why not something, you know, drier? Because you're a robot. You're a lot of electrical equipment now.
I mean, somewhere like Boise?
And we come full circle. We'll be right back, everybody. Equinox special, where we are celebrating the time between one solstice and another solstice, right, Jeff?
That's correct.
Nothing else to see here. My first guest tonight is in The Hunger Games. The movie I bored you about earlier on. It's meant to be awesome. It's in theaters on Friday. Take a look at this.
Oh.
Don't you take the name out of the sorting hat? I don't get it. Please welcome the lovely Elizabeth Banks, everybody.
You're color blocking. I can see you're color blocking. Yes.
You are so fancy with your color blocking.
I know about things.
Well, I guess so.
It's green. You look fine. It's the dark blue and then the other blue and all sorts
yes.
of.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you. Great. Color blocking.
Very nice.
That was a very serious clip.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. The character
it's sort
you
of
played,
a downer.
No, it was great. It really brought the show to a screeching halt.
Yeah. For sure.
No, but this movie's going to be huge. It's going to be enormous.
There's that's a very exciting moment in the actual movie, unlike the clip on the show played.
Yeah. But you got to take it in context. If you knew what was going on,
exactly.
If you'd been watching the movie. Right, I understand. Exactly. And your character, Pippa Middleton, is the...
Pippa.
Is the... what?
I'll take it.
Yeah.
The derriere on that Pippa.
Is that Pippa Middleton?
Yes.
I got to tell you, I went back and I watched that again.
I'd do anything to have that
not
behind.
So great.
What are you talking about?
Not so great. Yeah, listen, I look at women's asses a lot. I like.
It is a fine looking behind on Pippa.
I don't know. Okay.
Come on.
Okay.
Come on.
It wasn't. It's not J-Lo. You know, come on.
Who's J-Lo? I mean, that's a tough act to follow.
Do you know why once I was at a Hollywood event and it was a kind of theater? Yeah, the last time I went.
Sure.
And. I was sitting in a seat, and it was like in the theater, and she had to pass me. I had to stop, and it went right by me.
Right, like in your face.
Like I was like,
yes.
And in my head, as it was going by, I went da 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 da.
Did it knock your nose or anything?
Oh, I wish it had.
I used to ride the subway in New York City all the time when I lived in New York, and my biggest fear was a man's junko in the face. Because you sit and you're right at the same
right
level.
There, yeah.
And they all strap hang, as they say, which sounds sexual.
Sounds a bit dirty.
Yeah. So they're strap hanging right in your face with their junk.
Do you think guys do that on purpose? Do you think guys are like kind of like?
I hope not. I mean, exactly. It's like it's right there.
Yeah, no, it's terrible business.
It's horrible.
Although if you get the seat by the door, that's best place for it. Yeah.
Because you can do it and then get out.
No. I take the seat and watch.
Oh. I thought you were like hanging going.
No, I would never do that. That's
sure.
awful. Do you take a lot of public transport when you're in New York?
I do, actually.
Really?
I just took the subway the last time I was there.
Oh.
Yeah. It's the fastest way to get around. I get ill in the taxis.
You get ill?
I get like sick to my stomach in the taxis.
Why?
Also, I've been in two accidents in the backseat of taxis. Always wear your seatbelt in the back of the taxi.
Yes, that's true. CBS goes.
And...
No, you should, because people get in the back.
I slammed my head once against the divider.
Yeah, the bulletproof
and this
screen.
And this is the moneymaker.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, right
so
there.
You got to strap this in to the back of the taxi. So that's the other reason I don't go on it. No, but I get a little car sick.
Maybe wear a crash helmet.
Just like around?
Yeah, like around. I mean, you protect your assets.
Yeah, but then you can't see the moneymaker.
Well, you don't have to see it if you're on the day off.
You know
what I mean?
Well.
Just reveal it while you're working. And here I am.
I will take that under consideration.
No, good. You do look good, though. You do look very, very well.
Thank you very much.
You're doing something...
I work out and then try and eat well and, sure.
Are you one of them vegetarians?
No, I eat love meat.
Do you know,
can't get enough meat.
Let me tell you something weird about this.
What?
I got food poisoning about a month ago.
Worst.
It's awful, right?
Yeah.
And
you
it was
double under or one under?
Oh, no, everything. Bum, 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 ears,
everywhere.
Eyes, everything. I was like,
ah! Yeah, exactly.
Right?
That's what it's like.
And since then, I like to grill and barbecue and everything. I can't look at meat, can't do it.
What?
I know, it's crazy. I'm the reluctant vegetarian.
Nothing, like chicken even?
I'm,
can you do
like,
fish?
It was from a piece of chicken. I can't. I'm eating tofu. It's driving me crazy.
Yeah, I know. I mean, I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's a terrible thing.
It's
awful. Yeah.
Yeah, I had a burger yesterday. It looked delicious. It was delicious. I put an egg on it and everything.
See, what the hell?
Yeah.
Put an egg on your burger?
Well, yeah, my husband
and
I shared it at this... Well, what's so wrong with the French, really?
Well, an egg on your burger...
Can we get past this already?
What?
The French thing? I'm fine with the French. Like, let's just get good with it, right?
Egg on burger? You're fine with this, clearly?
Yes. They have some good ideas. They put butter in everything.
Yeah,
great idea.
No, I'll give you that.
They have the City of Lights. Great idea.
We took the show there. Look at you.
Yeah, but you tried to turn it American.
Well, I suggested this as a new color scheme. And it was met with some reluctance by our French brothers and sisters. They weren't keen on it.
I mean, I think they were very welcoming to your show.
No, they were. They were very nice. Do you spend a lot of time in Paris?
I wish. I'd like to spend more time there. No, really? I don't, though.
Have you ever been?
It's lovely, and I don't speak any French. Non parle François. I don't know. That's not even.
Sounded good enough to me. If you can't speak the language in Europe, there is a tip. Just speak English in the accent that you think they sound like.
They love that.
They love it. They appreciate the gesture.
They really do.
When you go, hello, it's nice to be here.
Exactly. They love it. That.
And in Germany, you're like, don't do a lot of this. They love that.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, have you been all around Europe, have you?
I have been, and we just went for the Hunger Games. We went to London and Paris and Berlin, speaking of France. And yeah, we didn't get to see a lot of the cities. I mean, we saw a lot of inside of hotel rooms.
Yeah.
Well, we talked about the movie a lot.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. I imagine it's like that in successful movie making.
I'd like to go back to Paris with my lovely husband.
So yeah, that'd be nice.
That would be nice.
Is he French, your husband?
No, but he studied it in high school, so he speaks like six words of it.
That's enough. That's all you need. With your ability
to... He can get us to the airport. He says fancy things like, bon. When someone says like, okay, no problem, sir. And he goes, bon. Which I think means like, okay, or good, or something.
Do you know a good one is, bien sûr?
What? What?
Bien sûr.
What's that mean?
It means of course.
Oh.
So you just go, bien sûr.
Bien sûr.
Yeah, bien sûr.
Bien sûr.
Yeah, I like that. And if you don't say it, just imagine yourself saying Beyoncé. Uh-huh. In a French accent. Bien sûr.
That's your Rosetta Stone right there.
Absolutely, right there.
Just like thinking of the English words that it could be.
Right,
like,
it could be Beyoncé.
I like that. No, I can say, bonjour, bonsoir.
That's it.
And that's it. Au revoir.
Yeah, that's all you need.
Right? A bientôt.
A bientôt. Adios.
No. That one.
Spanish people can't go to France all of a sudden.
I almost said arrivederci, but that's not one either.
No, but
they don't even say that, by the way. They say ciao. They don't really say arrivederci.
Well, ciao is a kind of all-purpose word. It's like aloha in Hawaii.
Yeah,
you just
exactly.
use it for everything.
All right, ciao. Yeah,
ciao. Yeah. Arrivederci.
We're so worldly.
Yeah, we are.
Aren't we?
Well, you with your color blocking.
So worldly, I know.
You look good, though. I like your shoes.
They're big.
Yeah.
Look how big these shoes are. You want to see it? Look, see
Don't put your shoe on the table. It's bad luck.
Why? It is?
Oh, it's bad luck, yeah.
Says who? The Japanese? I'm guessing. Is that right? Am I right? I just want to know if that's who it is.
No, my mother. My mother in Scotland.
Sorry, gosh.
Don't put your shoes on the table. 'Tis bad luck.
Was she also a witch? Like, what? Where's that voice from?
That was her voice.
Okay. Yeah, that's unfortunate.
She would turn into a cat from time to time. We have to take a commercial break.
Oh, no. Well, that's good for you, the show, I guess, because it means they're sponsors. Like, people are buying ads, which is good, I guess.
I don't know. As far as I can tell, it's just boner pills and the other thing that we do here. You wouldn't even say anything. We'll be right back, okay? We'll be right back. Welcome back. Did you enjoy your beverage?
I really liked that a lot.
Yeah, what is it you got in there?
I wish it was, it's agua.
French say it?
No.
How do the French say water?
Oh.
They do, yeah.
Oh.
I think they go like this, or they go, oh. Nice. So how are things doing with the baby? What age is your baby now?
Oh, yeah, I have a 12-month-old. He just had his birthday March 18th. Was his one-year birthday.
That's great. Congratulations.
Yes, my husband and I toasted to the fact that we made it through the year.
Yeah, that's good.
Which was
It's very frightening the first year, I think.
It is. I'm still scared. I still go in all the time to make sure he's alive.
Yeah, all the time. I do it with my 11-year-old as well, and he's like,
yeah.
Get out.
He's like, come on, right. No, it's very scary. He made the big milestone of becoming a biped, so he walked right before his
congratulations
birthday.
That's always a big moment.
It's a big deal. It was a big
this your husband we're talking about or
actually I think my husband is so relieved that I have a son to talk about, because normally I just come on the show and just kill my husband
on the air about him before.
He just is in the back just dying, so now he's, you know, I can just kill my
take
son
it out your kids.
Until
yeah,
my
yeah.
kid decides to be like, mommy.
Yeah, no, that my oldest son's like, you can't talk about me anymore.
Really?
Yeah, just knock it off. This is not your thing.
Yeah. No, that's true. I mean, he's a private citizen.
Yeah, and I get it. I'm like, I'm sorry, I apologize. And then he said, your grown-up jokes are not funny to me. And I said, my jokes are not grown-up. So, they're just not funny. Yeah, no, he's
That's a bummer.
Yeah, no, they get very sassy.
Yeah. I don't know.
Are you going to be a strict parent?
I'm trying to limit the no's right now, because I don't want everything to be a no, but...
Yeah, you'll join the rest of us soon.
It's tough, I know. I will. No, I actually am strict. My husband's he's the easy one, for sure. For sure I'm going to be the one that's like...
Well, you know...
Ah,
yeah.
Laying down the law.
Yeah.
We'll see when necessary.
He's walking now.
It's real, real cute. I mean, I was like, maybe he'll be like kind of a dummy about it and like not do it for a while. And my husband was like, I want to know.
Is your husband competitive?
My husband's competitive. So my husband was like, when did every other baby that we know walk? And will our son do it before then?
See, now
that's what he wanted to know. And I was like, you understand, once he can go, like, we're screwed.
Yes.
Like, it's over for us.
Once they're mobile, it's a whole different game.
For
then it's just zone defense.
He had a push toy that he pushed around and it made noise. So it was like, bah, 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 bah. I mean, it was really annoying.
Yeah.
But we knew where he was because we could hear him at all times.
Yeah, you couldn't see him, but you could
now,
hear him.
Now it's like he just, you know, he's in his little bare feet and he's shuffling around. You have no idea where the heck the kid is. I literally went to his room the other day and he wasn't there. And I freaked out. And it's like, where could he be? He can't go anywhere. But I just
was he down
had
at the bottom of the
a
driveway?
Panic what? Shoot through me.
Yeah.
No, he was like behind a door, but I didn't see him right away. So and he had his binky in his mouth, so he doesn't make. Usually, I can get him if I yell his name. He'll like talk, but nothing.
This is not your husband we're talking about.
Again, this is my 12-month-old son.
Not my husband.
Although he does that sometimes too.
What?
Well, he just doesn't want me to know where he is in the house.
He has his binky in his mouth. That's an agile young man. You know, I can wait, but I can't. We're out of time, so what do you fancy?
Oh, my goodness.
Mouth organ.
I'm so nervous about this.
What?
I don't know. I want to win the $50.
Oh, so you want to go for the big cash prize?
Yeah, I want the
what
big cash prize.
What time is it, Charles
David? It's time for the big cash prize.
Big cash prize. All right. Here's how you win the big cash prize.
Really?
Don't touch the bag until you win.
But is this really $50?
Yeah, in
quarters. Just right there, right now?
Yeah, $50.
That doesn't seem like a lot of quarters in that bag.
Feel the weight of that.
Can I really?
Yeah, feel the weight. Underneath.
I just feel like this is like $20. Like, how is that $50?
Would you like to? Would you like to take one out and bite it to make sure?
It's not that. It's that I feel like there's not enough in there to make $50.
Well, there
Am
is.
Am I crazy? Like,
yes. That's $50.
I imagine $50 in quarters is like I wouldn't even be able to carry it. It would be so heavy.
You're insane.
No,
this is $50 in quarters. Look,
I was very bad at math.
I tell you what, I've got here as well. I got $50 here in singles.
Well, that's what I want, because this, you know where you can use that. That's the one that I really want.
So you want this instead of this?
Yeah.
All right. So $50 in singles.
Okay.
You don't want the cash.
No.
The quarters.
Yeah, I'll take these instead. I'll take the pile instead.
Very unorthodox.
Can I still have the cool bag with the money sign
on it? No, you can't. Well, actually, yes. I'll just put the actual $50 in quarters right there.
That did
see?
Cool.
$50. Do you
but see,
count?
Here's why I can't take this, because that is a choking hazard for my son.
Okay, fair enough.
That's the main reason why I don't want that in my house. He'll just chew these, and then I won't be able to...
Yeah, you'll be all right. Yeah, you buy him a lot of little binkies.
That's true. We can get a lot of binkies.
All right, you ready?
Okay.
Two ways to win. You can either answer a question or guess what's in my box. Here's how that works. I imagine a box in my head, but I don't know what's in it. Only Jeff knows what's in the box.
Okay.
You try and guess what's in it. If you're right, he'll tell you. If you're wrong, you have to pay a forfeit.
What's that mean?
Means that something sexy happens to you.
To me? Or what?
With you.
Or I answer a question?
Or you answer a question.
You really scared me off there with the sexy thing.
Look, so you're going to win the money. No one never doesn't win the money. You're going to win the money.
Okay, I'm going to go for the question.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Okay.
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 Oh, come on.
All right.
Okay.
Iceland is in the North Atlantic. Its capital city is Reykjavik. If you hear a hospital intercom page, Dr. Brown, what does that generally mean? A, they're looking for Dr. Brown. B, someone in the emergency room is in trouble. Or C, there is a security threat in the building.
Wow.
You want me to do it again? Because I really don't want to.
No, Dr. Brown, I got it. Okay, they say Dr. Brown. You're saying it's either just they're looking for Dr. Brown.
Right.
Or it's a code for something.
Yeah, it's either emergency room or security threat code.
Dr. Brown. I feel like they're just looking for Dr. Brown.
Now, that's close.
No. But that's not my answer.
Right, I didn't think it was. Is she adorable?
It's just what I was thinking.
Yeah, I know, I get it.
But if I were gonna answer it,
yeah,
for real, I would say that it. I think in these post 9/11 times.
Hey, why don't you show your clip again if you want to do that?
That it means it's a security threat.
It is a security threat. You win $50.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Greg?
I know what you're thinking. Cats can't play the mouth organ. That's right, they can't. Do you know why? It's got nothing to do with their mouths, right, Jeff?
That's right.
That's right. They could physically do it with their little hey, meow mouths, but they don't have thumbs. Right, Jeff?
That's true.
Yeah. So what did we learn on the show tonight, Jeff?
That cats don't have thumbs.
That's right. Anything else?
We also learned that you're a reluctant vegetarian.
I am. I'd like to eat meat, but it makes me gag. All yours, buddy, all yours.
You want to go strap hanging later on?
Well, I'll hang on the strap if you sit in the seat by the door.
Now you're talking.